A very warm good day to all the viewers of today's do justice to as much as we can, and we've divided the entire topic into four subtopics: banquets, buffets. Yet buffets are kept separately because they are not necessarily, they are not formal, and if they were formal, they would transmute to becoming a banquet. Banquets such as luncheons, dinners, wedding breakfast, and sports banquets. And buffets such as wedding receptions, cocktail parties, buffet, teas, dances, anniversary parties, and conferences. A banquet is a large public meal or feast complete with main courses and desserts. Banquet usually serves a purpose such as a charitable gathering, a ceremony, or a celebration. It is often preceded or followed by speeches in honor of someone. Banquets have been used as a formal occasion for thousands of years. Kings during medieval times frequently threw banquets for special events such as birthdays, marriages, etc. Types of functions. There are several types of functions, but we've categorized them into three types: social, conferences, and public relations. Social functions include dinners, old boys, luncheons, clubs, societies, ladies' kitties, receptions, cocktail parties, and charity performances. Conferences include political conferences, trade unions, national and international sales conferences. And public relations functions include press party to launch a new product, fashion parade, dealers meetings, seminars, exhibitions. Banquet presentations. A buffet table setting has become one of the most delightful ways of entertaining large groups of people. Banquet presentation continues to gain popularity for weddings, bridal showers, and dinners. Party food displays are transformed into culinary works of art, enticing guests to the highlight of any affair, the food. Any banquet buffet, central part is the food. Buffet-style entertainment offers a flexible level of formality, easily adapted to fit any venue. The style of buffet table servers marks the distinction between a formal and an informal buffet presentation. Displays can be dressed up to convey elegance or dressed down to convey casual ease. Today, it is necessary to provide artful buffet party table settings and creative buffet style food choices. Necessary. The people of today, they don't want quality. They want eye appeal more than anything else. Which is all right, trend of the day. Please look at these banquet setups very carefully. If you want, you can take a screenshot. Such beautiful setups. Today is the 11th of June. It is 6 a.m. right now. A very pristine time. I can hear the birds chirping. I can hear the water filling my tanks, which gives me a spa or a sensation that I'm sitting near a river or a flowing water body stream, which is godly, heavenly. And the place is Dehradun. The weather is awesome, absolutely. I'm sitting on the top of my terrace. Moving on. What are the criteria for banquet presentation? The key to a successful buffet gathering is an efficient buffet table setup. When creating a buffet-style table setting, functionality is the key. It should be highly functional. Buffet party table settings should be inviting, yet encourage traffic flow. It is necessary in a buffet presentation to create a buffet table setup that will keep traffic flowing while also underlining the signature tone of the event. Creative buffet presentation ideas such as rotating buffet table displays or buffet stations are among the most popular buffet innovations. A buffet style table setting that rotate items with a new round of buffet style foods brought out when the previous is gone boosts the traffic flow while providing a flavorful mix of food. There are buffet stations set up around the room, each showcasing a different theme or type of buffet style foods. Buffet displays are the focal point of any buffet reception. The success of a buffet style event depends largely on the quality and taste of buffet style foods. The design of the buffet table settings and dazzling decor set the tone and brings the table to life. For a truly unforgettable buffet venue, everything from delectable buffet food menus to eye-catching buffet displays should be balanced to create both effective and artistic finesse. Please enjoy some creative buffet setups. The F&B managers go to great lengths in creating an unforgettable and an innovative experience for their guests. One of the good ways of doing that is by having creative buffet setups. Please take a screenshot of this. Or just quickly draw. This is a buffet, a very common sight known to all of us, just to remind. I had discussed this presentation with our F&B service team, and Mr. Azhar Hussain said, "Sir, you've been speaking breakfast, lunch and dinner. What about snacks?" So he presented me a photograph. Mr. Azhar Hussain is the coordinator of IHM Meerut, and I've included his photograph in this presentation. It's about snacks. So snacks, you know, snacks are meals within meals. So between breakfast and lunch, whatever we eat is snacks, and between lunch and dinner, whatever we eat is snacks, or between dinner and breakfast the next day, whatever we eat is snacks. And snack presentation, snacks is like a huge thing. Balance of colors, shapes, textures and flavors should be there. Preparation and cooking. Preparing foods properly. Foods prepared properly show the expertise of the chef and the kitchen staff. Cutting foods. Careful cutting of foods will increase the eye appeal and reflect the chef's attention to detail. There is a difference between cutting foods to decorate the plate and cutting foods to be consumed. And molding foods. Some foods can be molded by using metal rings, circular cutters. These molds can create height and width and make the plate neat and clean. This is a sample working lunch buffet. If you can see my pointer, Number one is forks and linen pocket. Number two is plates at the beginning of the buffet. Plates and forks and everything else is kept. Number three is votive candles. Votive candles are white candles, small candles, which are used during prayers. In India, we use diyas. So a little place for votive for praying to God before we begin the meal. Four is forks, five is napkins, six is grilled New Zealand lamb chops on raised rectangular silver platter. And here on the back you see a small plate with tongs on top for the server to pick up the lamb chops and serve to the guest. Number seven is tomato Napoleon in a rectangular chafing dish. Tomato Napoleon is, as you all probably know, is a salad made of thinly sliced tomatoes with cheese, lettuces and dressings, and it's a very famous dish. It is a very good combination to both New Zealand lamb chops and to the chicken roulade, which is kept here, number nine. So number seven is tomato Napoleon, and again we see a fork. No, this is the first time we see a fork on a plate. This is a large service fork from which the tomatoes can be scooped and served to the guest. At number eight, we see a large round display of a dip in the center, punch bowl in the center, and baby lettuces on the side. Baby lettuces on the side, punch bowl in the center, just to balance the meal, you see? Just to balance the meal. There is no lettuce anywhere. And on the side, you see another tongs for scoop, for picking up the lettuce and serving to the guest. At nine, as I told earlier, is the roulade of chicken. Roulade of chicken and leeks. Roulade is a roll of chicken. It's like a long cylindrical roll of chicken in which various stuffings are used, and then it is sliced into discs about a centimeter thick and about 2 inches in diameter into discs, and then it is served. At number 10, we have haricot worts and orange salad on a raised oval silver platter. This is vegetable. Moving on, this is a pictorial description of a buffet, salad buffet. Beautiful. Lighting is important. The reason I'm sitting on the terrace and making this presentation is lighting. Nothing to beat natural light. Enhancing presentations. You can enhance presentations by the use of unusual containers like metal and exotic wood to showcase breads, crackers, and specialty breads or accompaniments. During celebrations, a popular trend is to collect and display various shapes and colors of glasses as an icebreaker. Use of glass blocks that may be used for interior and decoration of the dining area. And enhancing presentations can be done by a mix of fruits and fresh flowers, which are essential to the finishing touch of any tabletop. Incorporating herbs and greenery in food presentation and tabletop adds aroma and color. The use of glass votives, candles kept in glass for prayer, to illuminate a desktop is an inexpensive way to create warmth and ambience. Successful food presentation is all about the details. Chipped crockery or unclean cutlery is a big no-no. No, never. No chipped crockery and no unclean cutlery should ever be used. It is a big turn-off. Use of serving platters in glass and porcelain as individual dinner plates. See, flowers make such a big difference, and placards, menu card holders, they make the experience so vivid. The guests can easily discern, can easily understand and explain dishes to others. Beautiful presentations. This image on the left, thumbnail of this video, I loved it absolutely. Vegetable carvings, a means of enhancing the banquet or the buffet display. And on the right, you see a huge, massive spread of dishes, which is possible only in buffets. A la carte or table d'hôte, we cannot offer such a huge variety. These are some banquets, elegant banquets, food, and the setup of the banquet on the right, top right. A small recap on the menus. There are three types of menus. There are many more types of menus, but primarily, broadly, there are three types of menus: table d'hôte, a la carte, and banquet menus. Table d'hôte menus are a set menu forming a complete meal at a set price. A la carte menus are a menu with all the dishes individually priced, card by the card, and banquet menus are for banquets or for functions of all kinds. What are buffets? We move on from banquets to buffets now. What are buffets? Buffets are a meal serving system in which the patrons or the guests serve themselves. Buffets are a popular method of feeding large number of people with minimal staff. I remember in Doha, we used to do a party of 100 people with just two waiters. I was the executive chef there, and 100 people with just two servers. That's it. Minimal staff. And I do remember my days in the a la carte kitchen, where for a 200 or a 250 cover restaurant, we used to need a whole brigade of servers and a whole brigade of cooks just for 200 people. And in banquet organizations such as Uday Vilas and other places which are surviving because of banquets, they serve 1,000 people with just 10 people, perhaps 5 in the kitchen, 5 in the service area. They do 1,000 people just like that. When I was in Doha, Qatar, in the flight kitchen, we used to do 10,000 meals a day. We were just 28 people in the kitchen. 28 people in the kitchen, we used to do 10,000 meals a day. Amazing. So, buffets offer a popular method of feeding large numbers of people with minimal staff. And buffets were initially sideboards. Buffet came later. Initially, it was serviced from the sideboard, which was used to offer the dishes of a buffet meal to guests in a private home. How did the buffets emerge? Modern buffets developed in France in the 18th century. Originally referred to the sideboard where the food was served. Buffets revived in England and France. New ideals of privacy made the modicum of self-service. People didn't want to be served. People wanted to serve themselves. In the modern day, people wanted to, when I'm talking about modern day, I'm not talking about today, I'm talking about 100 years ago. So, people wanted to serve themselves, which is how the buffets emerged. And of course, we must mention the contribution by old country buffets of USA, which is a trademark, which is a company which really brought meaning to buffets, to not only the USA but to the whole world. People used to go to old country buffets just to enjoy the buffet experience, to be able to see those lavish spread of dishes, all you can eat for that fixed price, anything that you want to eat, you can go ahead and really indulge yourself. Buffets served in hotel banquet functions such as wedding reception, conferences, small get-togethers, state banquets. Buffets in coffee shop for breakfast, lunch and dinner. Different buffets, industrial catering menus. These are menus which are served to people at their place of work. Kids menus in schools. There is an emphasis on healthy eating and a healthy diet, balanced diet. Types of buffets, line of food serving stalls filled with fixed portions of food in cafeterias. All you can eat buffet is free in form in restaurants and in major casinos. A third type of buffet commonly called offered is a salad bar in delicatessen and supermarkets. Delicatessen is like a shop which displays cold cuts of meat, cheese, different types of cheeses, and it sells from, so it's a large display and it is a shop from where the food is sold. Standard buffet is a compromise between self-service and full table service. Diners bring their own plate along the buffet line and are given a portion from the server. Standard buffets are popular in conventions and conferences. Smorgasbord from Sweden, table of sandwiches. Yesterday I did a presentation on bread making and sandwiches. The world of sandwiches is so amazing. You must please, when you find time, visit this presentation. It is available on YouTube on my channel. A plethora, a whole world of sandwiches. It will open your eyes, I'm sure. A buffet setting requires planning with regard to layout and easy access to your guests. Any type of party at any time of the day is possible. Breakfast and brunches, lunches and afternoon teas, and appetizers or dinners. Traffic flow and a food pattern are essential to the success of a buffet line. Decor is secondary, but should always present a welcome approach from any direction. When planning your buffet layout, please keep in mind how you want your guests to travel from one food item to the next. Keep the accessway clear from kitchen to the tables. How to keep beverage traffic separated from the food traffic, and how you will handle ongoing cleanup that is unobtrusive for your guests. Open tables are more inviting as guests can access various foods without having to start at the beginning. Fresh plates should be easily accessible at the starting point. To create a structured path, place meats first, followed by hot and cold vegetables and salads. Keep the necessary condiments in one place, but leave plenty of prep room. Before COVID-19, the trends were less stuffy ballroom dinners. Earlier, the ballrooms used to be jam-packed. People used to rub against each other. But just before COVID-19, the latest trends are that these ballrooms are not as stuffed as they used to be. Celebrity function settings and menus. Restaurant-like experiences. So even in the banquet, people want to you know, feel as if they were in a restaurant. Extra snacks, live snacks being cooked live. More global and multi-cuisine, directly from plant to plate, and no replenishment but replacement. Post-COVID-19, the trends have changed. The trends will change, I would say. Buffets and banquets are an integral part of our lives since thousands of years. They are not going to go away because of the COVID menace. There will be alterations, lesser number of people, adequate distancing between guests and staff, limited access to buffets, food doled out by trained hotel staff only, enhanced use of packed and pre-plated foods, increased costs, and state-of-the-art hygiene practice. These inputs were provided by Mr. Ashish Tyagi, who is a coordinator at IHM Meerut. This is what we think it will be after the COVID menace is dealt with. What customers expect? Customers expect to eat in a more healthy manner. Special food giving rise to the increasing popularity of buffets for everyone. The health trends these days are leaning towards organic foods, low-fat foods, low-carbohydrate offerings, sugar-free options, no trans fats, no corn syrup, bad food with good ingredients not acceptable. Instead of donuts and danish, pure flour products, trendy order items which contain nutritional. Dark chocolates are good. They prevent cholesterol from accumulating in the blood vessels and they reduce the risk of blood clots. Customers expect miniature proportions and interactive presentations. Now these are the different kinds of menus in more detail. Table d'hote, a la carte, banquet menus as told earlier. And then there are four more. Ethnic or specialty menus, hospital menus, industrial catering menus, and kids menus. Table d'hote is a set menu forming a complete meal at a set price. A la carte is a menu with all the dishes individually priced by the card. And banquet menus are for banquets or functions of all kinds. Ethnic or specialty menus can be table d'hote or a la carte, specializing in the food or religion of a country in a specialized food itself. Hospital menus usually take the form of a menu card given to the patient the day before service so that his or her preferences can be ticked. Industrial catering menus, these are menus which are served to people at their place of work. And kids menus, last but not the least, in schools where there is emphasis on healthy eating and a balanced diet. These were the different types of menus. Cyclic menu is made for a period. It consists of a set number of menu items. Length of the cycle is determined by management policy, time of the year, and different types of ingredients available. The advantages of a cyclic menu: saves time, may require slight altercations, may require slight alterations, give greater efficiency, cut down the number of commodities, and a cyclic menu helps planning the storage requirement of any organization. Before the menu is planned, we have now moved on to the third aspect of the presentation today. The first aspect was banquets, the second was buffets, the third is menu planning, and the fourth one is food presentation. So considerations prior to planning the menu: type of establishment, type of clientele, type of occasion or function, location, religious beliefs, availability of raw materials, availability of manpower, competition in the locality, paying capacity of the guests, type of space and equipment required, range of items and price, seat turnover, meat and non-meat preferences, seasonal availability of raw materials, number of courses, correct sequence of courses, length, better to offer fewer dishes, length of the menu card, better to offer fewer dishes of good standard than a long list of mediocre quality, design of the menu. Design should complement the image of the dining room and be designed to allow for changes. Menu balancing pointers, language should be accurate. There is no room for any ambiguity. Avoid over elaboration and flowery choice of words. Wherever possible, use English language. Presentation. A sensible and welcoming way so that the customer is put at ease and is relaxed. An offhand brusque presentation, written or oral, jaldibaji, can be off-putting and lower expectations of the meal. Texture of the courses should not be all soft or all crisp or all crunchy, but it should be balanced. A little bit of this and a little bit of that. Sauces, the foundation ingredient of each sauce should vary. So some sauces should be flour-based, other sauces should be puree-based, whereas some other sauces should be sugar-based or whatever else, thickening agent-based. No repetition of wines. No repetition of commodities, no repetition of flavors, no repetition of colors, and there should be a sensible nutritional balance. All six components, carbohydrates, proteins, minerals, fats, vitamins, everything should be balanced. There should be everything in your food. Menu policy. Establish the essential and social needs of the customer. Accurately predict what the customer is likely to buy and how much he or she is going to spend. Provide a means of communication. Purchase and prepare raw materials to preset standards. Effectively control the complete operation from purchase to service on the plate. Now we move on to the last part of today's presentation, which is again presentation of food. As you all know, while we are next only to the army in terms of discipline, we also boast of ourselves to be in the business of showmanship. Presentation is very important. Presentation of the food, presentation of ourselves, presentation of the premises, presentation of the way we write and the way we do things. So presentation is the key. Any time you are in a public area, in a hotel, please understand, you should consider that you are on stage, you are performing. You are not working, you are not serving, you are not cooking, you are not anything. You are performing as if you were on a stage. So presentation of the food, it is very important to have a nice background. There are two types of presentations, classical and contemporary. On the left bottom you see a casserole. That is the classical style of presentation. You know, plain, simple and no frills and, you know, clean. But and on the right hand side, top right hand side above the video, you see the contemporary or the modern style of presenting food. Sides have changed so much thanks to the modern day chefs, especially the nouvelle cuisine. The nouvelle cuisine really made a whole lot of difference to how we look at food today. While presenting foods, please consider the following: likes and dislikes of the guest, number of guests, occasion, the demographics of the guest, repetitions in the menu, type of menu, sequence of the meal, choices offered, type of cuisine, accompaniment and garnishes, the eye eats first is a very famous saying. The food should be absolutely splendid to look at. The creativity and skill to be placed on the plate. All great plate presentations take skill, experience, and style. Skill, experience, and style. Presentation is the process of offering the selected foods to guests in a fashion that is visually pleasing. Types of food presentation: pre-plated presentation, silver-plated presentation, silver service presentation, buffets, themes, cuisine specific, trolleys, food displays, food courts. All these terms are quite common and I don't think I should elaborate. Atmosphere and settings: how do we create an atmosphere? By sizzling sounds in the restaurant, by enticing aromas, by presenting the food at the right temperature, covers removed to release captured smells, and voila, you remove the lid and the flavor comes and hits the nose of the guest, and the right music in the restaurant really sets the atmosphere. Purpose of the presentation: balancing colors, balancing textures, balancing nutrition, balancing contemporary dietary trends. So how do we balance colors by presentation? So we see that the colors blue and black are not so common in food. So our decor could be blue or black colored so that the food is balanced in color, so that all kinds of colors are given to the guest. How do we balance the textures? You see, a lot of hotels do not feature fruits and salads and salad leaves and the condiments and stuff on their foods. We can balance the texture by providing these side dishes to the guest. How do we balance the nutrition? Same as above. And balancing contemporary dietary trends, the modern dietary trends. The modern day trends are that almost everybody is sugar conscious, is fat conscious, is organic conscious. So all these modern day contemporary dietary trends have to be addressed. Cannot ignore any of that. Now this is how the ancient day people used to show lavishness. You see, the foods are just put in a bowl, they are with gravies, and this is how lavishness used to be earlier times. Today lavishness has adopted a totally new different menu. Please watch the lavishness of today for yourself in the next slide. Here goes. Lo and behold, people, I think it deserves a round of applause. This is how the modern day dish looks. The plate is like a white canvas on which an artist paints with food, something else altogether. We moved a long way from how we were. It should be mentioned, food for the camera should be mentioned. Now, food for the camera is not the food for your stomach, which is something else. It is food which is created in such a way that it looks appealing to the camera for marketing and for sales. Food for the camera, food is coaxed into pleasant shapes, coaxed, forced into pleasant shapes by the use of tweezers, syringes. So foods are injected with liquids to make them look plump and moist and juicy. Sprayers, there are different kinds of sprayers which are used to give different colors, and dry ice which gives smoke and the appearance of being chilled. They employ refillable butane torches for browning. So foods are browned with blow torches. Paint strippers to help with cheese melts. Melted cheese, very difficult to picturize, but with the help of paint strippers, very easy. Stylists employ hairspray. So the hairspray is used on food, you know, just so that it looks more stylish. It is very difficult to photograph water and ice. So aqua gel is used to make realistic looking water droplets or to thicken sauces. And last but not least, it is very difficult to photograph ice creams because they tend to melt quickly. So what photographers do is they use mashed potatoes. They add different colors to mashed potatoes. For example, they'll put pink color into mashed potatoes and we'll call it strawberry ice cream. They'll put say chocolate brown color into mashed potatoes and say call it chocolate ice cream. So instead of using ice cream, they use mashed potato scoops and then photograph them as ice cream. I remember of our time in the Doha Sheraton where we used to have to serve ice cream to say 1,000 people. We used to pre-scoop the ice cream and put them in bowls and then put the bowls into deep freezers. So at the time of the banquets, we would just take out 10-20 bowls out of the freezer and put it on the plate, and each scoop was like a piece of work, you know, because we had done it at leisure and then we had frozen it. They were solid frozen. So by the time the guest takes them and puts them on his plate and goes back to his table to eat, they are of the perfect temperature and they are not melting and messy as they otherwise are. The purpose of presentation is balancing colors and textures to provide a nutritional basis. The mixture and distribution of ingredients, search of amusement, playing a competitive game. Types of food presentations: pre-plated, silver service presentation, buffets, themes, and cuisine specific. Presentation of food, visual composition of state readiness to be eaten, signature of stylish cooks. Concept of plate presentation, creativity, hygiene, cost, and speed. Here are some plate presentations. We are almost at the end of today's session. How attractive. See? Intricacies of plate presentation. It is a work of art, involves immense rework if distributed during pickup, if disturbed during pickup. Efficiency and standardization in the kitchen is the key to a classy presentation. The eye appeal can make or break a meal experience. Well presented is well eaten. Gone are the times when presentation was not important. Today, the modern day people, they want the food to be absolutely good looking. Otherwise, they will just reject it and they say, we are not hungry, we don't want to have it. Factors affecting plate presentation: plate color, theme, type of food, course, and cuisine. That brings us to the end. I wish I could go on and on, on and on and on and on. But then, like anything else, this too shall end. And that goes so well for COVID. A very warm good day to all the viewers of today's live recorded broadcast of the topic Function Catering. This is an integral part of food and beverage management. It is a huge topic, Function Catering. We have thought that we should do justice to as much as we can, and we've divided the entire topic into four subtopics: banquets, buffets, menu planning for functions, and food presentation. Please enjoy, ladies and gentlemen. Function catering has been divided into two main categories: formal meals, banquets, and the semi-formal or informal meals, buffets. Now, while buffets are an integral part of functions of banquets, yet buffets are kept separately because they are not formal. And if they were formal, they would transmute to becoming a banquet. Banquets such as luncheons, dinners, wedding breakfast, and sports banquets, and buffets such as wedding receptions, cocktail parties, buffet, teas, dances, anniversary parties, and conferences. A banquet is a large public meal or feast complete with main courses and desserts. Banquet usually serves a purpose such as a charitable gathering, a ceremony, or a celebration. It is often preceded or followed by speeches in honor of someone. Banquets have been used as a formal occasion for thousands of years. Kings during medieval times frequently threw banquets for special events such as birthdays, marriages, etc. Types of functions. There are several types of functions, but we've categorized them into three types: social, conferences, and public relations. Social functions include dinners, old boys, luncheons, clubs, societies, ladies' kitties, receptions, cocktail parties, and charity performances. Conferences include political conferences, trade unions, national and international sales conferences. And public relations functions include press party to launch a new product, fashion parade, dealers meetings, seminars, exhibitions. Banquet presentations A buffet table setting has become one of the most delightful ways of entertaining large groups of people. Banquet presentation continues to gain popularity for weddings, bridal showers, and dinners. Party food displays are transformed into culinary works of art, enticing guests to the highlight of any affair, the food. Any banquet buffet, central part is the food. Buffet-style entertainment offers a flexible level of formality, easily adapted to fit any venue. The style of buffet table service marks the distinction between a formal and an informal buffet presentation. Displays can be dressed up to convey elegance or dressed down to convey casual ease. Today, it is necessary to provide artful buffet party table settings and creative buffet style food choices. Necessary. The people of today, they don't want quality. They want eye appeal more than anything else. Which is all right, trend of the day. Please look at these banquet setups very carefully. If you want, you can take a screenshot. Such beautiful setups. Today is the 11th of June. It is 6 a.m. right now. A very pristine time. I can hear the birds chirping. I can hear the water filling my tanks, which gives me a spa or a sensation that I'm sitting near a river or a flowing water body stream, which is godly, heavenly. And the place is Dehradun. The weather is awesome, absolutely. I'm sitting on the top of my terrace. Moving on. What are the criteria for banquet presentation? The key to a successful buffet gathering is an efficient buffet table setup. When creating a buffet style table setting, functionality is the key. It should be highly functional. Buffet party table settings should be inviting, yet encourage traffic flow. It is necessary in a buffet presentation to create a buffet table setup that will keep traffic flowing while also underlining the signature tone of the event. Creative buffet presentation ideas such as rotating buffet table displays or buffet stations are among the most popular buffet innovations. A buffet style table setting that rotate items with a new round of buffet style foods brought out when the previous is gone boosts the traffic flow while providing a flavorful mix of food. There are buffet stations set up around the room, each showcasing a different theme or type of buffet style foods. Buffet displays are the focal point of any buffet reception. The success of a buffet style event depends largely on the quality and taste of buffet style foods. The design of the buffet table settings and dazzling decor set the tone and brings the table to life. For a truly unforgettable buffet venue, everything from delectable buffet food menus to eye-catching buffet displays should be balanced to create both effective and artistic finesse. Please enjoy some creative buffet setups. The F&B managers go to great lengths in creating an unforgettable and an innovative experience for their guests. One of the good ways of doing that is by having creative buffet setups. Please take a screenshot of this. Or just quickly draw. This is a buffet, a very common sight known to all of us, just to remind. I had discussed this presentation with our F&B service team, and Mr. Azhar Hussain said, "Sir, you've been speaking about breakfast, lunch and dinner. What about snacks?" So he presented me a photograph. Mr. Azhar Hussain is the coordinator of IHM Meerut, and I've included his photograph in this presentation. It's about snacks. So snacks, you know, snacks are meals within meals. So between breakfast and lunch, whatever we eat is snacks, and between lunch and dinner, whatever we eat is snacks, or between dinner and breakfast the next day, whatever we eat is snacks. And snack presentation, snacks is like a huge thing. Balance of colors, shapes, textures and flavors should be there. Preparation and cooking. Preparing foods properly. Foods prepared properly show the expertise of the chef and the kitchen staff. Cutting foods. Careful cutting of foods will increase the eye appeal and reflect the chef's attention to detail. There is a difference between cutting foods to decorate the plate and cutting foods to be consumed. And molding foods. Some foods can be molded by using metal rings, circular cutters. These molds can create height and width and make the plate neat and clean. This is a sample working lunch buffet. If you can see my pointer, number one is forks and linen pocket. Number two is plates at the beginning of the buffet, plates and forks and everything else is kept. Number three is votive candles. Votive candles are white candles, small candles, which are used during prayers. In India, we use diyas, so a little place for votive for praying to God before we begin the meal. Four is forks, five is napkins, six is grilled New Zealand lamb chops on raised rectangular silver platter. And here on the back, you see a small plate with tongs on top for the server to pick up the lamb chops and serve to the guest. Number seven is tomato Napoleon in a rectangular chafing dish. Tomato Napoleon is, as you all probably know, is a salad made of thinly sliced tomatoes with cheese, lettuces and dressings. And it's a very famous dish. It is a very good combination to both New Zealand lamb chops and to the chicken roulade, which is kept here, number nine. So number seven is tomato Napoleon, and again we see a fork. No, this is the first time we see a fork on a plate. This is a large service fork from which the tomatoes can be scooped and served to the guest. At number eight, we see a large round display of a dip in the center, punch bowl in the center, and baby lettuces on the side. Baby lettuces on the side, punch bowl in the center, just to balance the meal, you see? Just to balance the meal. There is no lettuce anywhere. And on the side, you see another tongs for scoop, for picking up the lettuce and serving to the guest. At nine, as I told earlier, is the roulade of chicken. Roulade of chicken and leeks. Roulade is a roll of chicken. It's like a long cylindrical roll of chicken in which various stuffings are used, and then it is sliced into discs about a centimeter thick and about 2 inches in diameter into discs, and then it is served. At number 10, we have haricot worts and orange salad on a raised oval silver platter. This is vegetable. Moving on. This is a pictorial description of a buffet, salad buffet. Beautiful. Lighting is important. The reason I'm sitting on the terrace and making this presentation is lighting. Nothing to beat natural light. Enhancing presentations. You can enhance presentations by the use of unusual containers like metal and exotic wood to showcase breads, crackers, and specialty breads or accompaniments. During celebrations, a popular trend is to collect and display various shapes and colors of glasses as an icebreaker. Use of glass blocks that may be used for interior and decoration of the dining area. And enhancing presentations can be done by a mix of fruits and fresh flowers, which are essential to the finishing touch of any tabletop. Incorporating herbs and greenery in food presentation and tabletop adds aroma and color. The use of glass votives, candles kept in glass for prayer, to illuminate a desktop is an inexpensive way to create warmth and ambience. Successful food presentation is all about the details. Chipped crockery or unclean cutlery is a big no-no. No, never. No chipped crockery and no unclean cutlery should ever be used. It is a big turn off. Use of serving platters in glass and porcelain as individual dinner plates. See, flowers make such a big difference, and placards, menu card holders, they make the experience so vivid. The guests can easily discern, can easily understand and explain dishes to others. Beautiful presentations. This image on the left, thumbnail of this video, I loved it absolutely. Vegetable carvings, a means of enhancing the banquet or the buffet display. And on the right, you see a huge, massive spread of dishes, which is possible only in buffets. A la carte or table d'hote, we cannot offer such a huge variety. These are some banquets, elegant banquets, food, and the setup of the banquet on the right, top right. A small recap on the menus. There are three types of menus. There are many more types of menus, but primarily, broadly, there are three types of menus. Table d'hote,